this time, I'd ask everyone to stand and ask Commissioner Orrick to lead us in prayer and the pledge.
Thank you, dear Heavenly Father, for this good day. Bless us our life through Jesus. Watch over our family, our friends, and watch over our citizens, dear Heavenly Father, this evening. Bless us a long life's journey. Give us knowledge and understanding to make the best decisions for our county, dear Heavenly Father. Watch over our children, Lord, as they grow up and become adults, Lord, and guide them and be with them, dear Heavenly Father. Thank you for all that you do for us in our life. Thank you for the blessings. Thank you for our friends and our loved ones, dear Heavenly Father. Most of all, dear Heavenly Father, I thank you for the plan of salvation. Amen. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Okay, take the roll. Everyone, press your present button and press your confirm button. Where's your remote, Mr. Baird?
I
saw him over there trying to dial, trying to mark himself present on your phone.
He's had a rough day.
Help him out over there. Okay. Okay, we have 12 members present. Terry Singley, Wendell Bailey, and Marie Ayers are absent. We have a quorum. Shall entertain a motion to approve the minutes of the previous meeting. They're in your packet.
Make a motion to approve the minutes of the previous meeting.
Got a motion by Orrick, seconded by Sue Nance, to approve the minutes of the previous meeting. Any questions, any discussion? Ready to vote. All those in favor of approval, vote yes. Then press your confirmed button. Those opposed, vote no. Come on. Anyone wish to change your vote? Show us the vote, ma'am. 12 yes, 3 absent. Marie Ayers, Wendell Bailey, and Terry Singley are absent. Next is the Notary Public renewals.
Make a motion we approve the renewals.
We got a motion by Orrick, seconded by Sue Nance. The notary renewals are Misty Ann Kidwell, J. Kent Baker, and M. Smith. Any discussion, any questions? Okay, all those in favor, vote yes. Then press your confirmed button. Those opposed, vote no. David.
Yes.
Anyone wish to change your vote? Show us the vote, ma'am. 12 yes, 3 absent. Marie Ayers, Wendell Bailey, and Terry Singley are absent. Next is we have two new applicants. Entertain a motion to approve them.
Motion to approve the new applicants.
Motion by Orrick, seconded by Johnny Bruce. The new applicants are James Keith Clotfelter, Yvonne Sue Dean. Any discussion, any questions? All those in favor, vote yes. Then press your confirmed button. Those opposed, vote no. Anyone wish to change your vote? Show us the vote. 12 yes and 3 absent. Marie Ayers, Wendell Bailey, and Terry Singley are absent. Yes, we need to do a voice call on the notary renewals first.
Atkins, yes. Bayer, yes. Bruce, yes. Davis, yes. Evans, yes. Hall, yes. Hatmaker, yes. Nance, yes. Orrick, yes. Rutherford, yes. Walden, yes. And White, yes.
And then on the new applicants.
Atkins, yes. Bayer, yes. Bruce, yes. Davis, yes. Evans, yes. Hall, yes. Hatmaker, yes. Nance, yes. Orrick, yes. Rutherford, yes. Walden, yes. And White, yes.
Okay, moving on. The next item is approval of committee reports and minutes.
Motion to approve the committee reports and minutes.
To include the budget and finance minutes of 6:10 and 6:13 were handed out tonight. Do I have a second? Bobby White seconds the motion. Any discussion, any questions? Okay, all those in favor, vote yes. Then press your confirmed button. Those opposed, vote no. Anyone wish to change your vote? Show us the vote, ma'am. 12 yes, 3 absent. Marie Ayers, Wendell Bailey, and Terry Singley are absent. Next is the budget amendments and resolutions. Entertain a motion to approve the budget amendments.
Motion to approve resolution budget 6-1 through 6-12.
Do I hear a second? Second by J.L. Davis. Any questions, any discussion? All those in favor, vote yes. Then press your confirmed button. Those opposed, vote no.
David Atkins.
Anyone wish to change your vote? Show us the vote, ma'am. Got 11 yes, Tom Hatmaker voting no, and 3 absent. Marie Ayers, Wendell Bailey, and Terry Singley are absent.
I'm sorry, I didn't get time distracting me. I want to ask a question about 6-5.
Okay.
Just to ask Richard. Does this represent paying the debt, the outstanding lunch charge? Is that what that represents, or?
This amount just deals with the revenues within the 143 fund?
Correct.
Not related to the student card and adult card.
Okay. That was my question.
Mr. Chairman.
Mr. Atkins.
We've got three budget resolutions in front of us for a continued resolution on the budget this year. One of them's a 31-day, the other one's a 62-day, and the other one's a 92-day continuing resolution. I make a motion to approve the 62-day continuing resolution.
We have a motion and by Atkins, seconded by Bobby White, to approve a continuing resolution for 62 days. Any questions? Everybody ready to vote? All those in favor, vote yes. Then press your confirmed button. Those opposed, vote no. Anyone wish to change your vote? Show us the vote. 12 yes, 3 absent. Marie Ayers, Wendell Bailey, and Terry Singley are absent. Okay, next is there something else we need to do? Hey, Richard, is there anything else that we need to do as far as the...
On the budget, I just wait until the recess meeting on the 27th.
Okay, I got you. Okay. Next is I'll entertain a motion to approve all the reports.
So moved.
Got a motion by Orrick, seconded by Johnny Bruce to approve the reports. Any discussion, any question? All those in favor, vote yes. Then press your confirmed button. Those opposed, vote no. Anyone wish to change your vote? Show us the vote. 12 yes, 3 absent. Marie Ayers, Wendell Bailey, and Terry Singley are absent. Next is designating July 18th Harry Burden Appreciation Day. Jay Willoughby is doing that, but have you heard anything back from him?
I have not.
We sent him some more information Friday, I guess. Well, he'll get it done, but we just need to approve doing that. Motion by Sue Nance, seconded by Rusty Orrick. Anybody have any questions? All those in favor, vote yes. Then press your confirmed button. Those opposed, vote no. It's July the 18th. And he has been chairman of the grand jury for how many years, Joe?
39 years.
He got the job and couldn't get rid of it. Okay, next, there's three state highway contracts. Two of them are just for they're asking us to be responsible for the caution lights, school zone lights over at Elk Valley Elementary School. The one at Glade Springs has no traffic signal, just has some signage, some rumble strips, and that sort of thing. One of them at Elk Valley is like a 200 and what is it? What's the?
One's like 247,000. The other one's it's about 400,000. I'll give it to go there. It's just the guardrails and wrapping. And the only thing we'll maintain is just the two caution lights. That's good.
One is 223,900, one's 201,500, and one of them is 47,800. I'll entertain a motion to approve those.
I'm going to make a motion to go ahead and approve it. I'm going to discuss it a little bit further.
Alvin, we'll let Alvin make the motion, and Rusty will second the motion.
It don't matter.
Okay. Rusty.
The lights is the only thing we're going to have to keep up on the maintenance agreement, so we'll actually have a contract on those lights ourselves.
Yes.
And that'll be in front of us somewhere down the road, I guess.
No.
Okay.
If you approve this tonight, then I'll go ahead and sign the contract for them to go ahead with the installation with the agreement that we'll maintain or... And that maintenance agreement means that we'll...
What if the contract is not suitable, Mayor? I mean, is it...
It's
just trying to make it hard
it's
core,
just
but... Two lights, I understand. And that's the only thing that concerns is just the lights. And
right.
They didn't see no need for any lights at Glade Springs.
No.
Caution lights or anything like that.
No traffic signal.
Is it the same ones did the... that stamped these lights here in town for us and pointed them out to be put in? Undoubtedly don't know a whole lot's going on.
Whoever the TDOT folks are, whoever they got in charge of that part of their operation.
So we were giving you approval to the contract?
To sign the contract. Any other questions? Tom Hatmaker.
The rumble strips, are we in charge of the maintenance on those also?
Don't think so.
Okay.
Just the contract is just actually for the lights, the traffic signals.
Let me ask you, lights are already there. We already had to maintain them for school anyway, right?
The lights are already there. They're just replacing them, changing them a little bit, and they're going to be solar lights, and we asked the fellow, it's cost, I believe he said $1,250 if you had to replace them. But the likelihood of having to do that, since the lights are already there and everybody's used to having them, and it's So I don't think that there's going to be a big probability that we're going to have to replace them.
Mayor, that's good.
We asked them about the solar powered lights, and they said they hadn't had any that they've had a problem with or had to replace.
The agreement between the state and the county is just we will maintain them. We're not going to actually sign a contract with a company that they come out and inspect them once a year. When they need work, we'll call or
right.
State.
Yeah, okay. There's no contract between
a maintenance company come out and
if
claim
something
the
happens to them, we're just saying, yes,
we'll take care of it.
That's all. Ready to vote. All those in favor, vote yes, then press your confirmed button. Those opposed, vote no. Anyone wish to change your vote? Show us the vote. 12 yes, 3 absent. Marie Ayers, Wendell Bailey, and Terry Singley are absent. And the next one is the Veterans Affairs copier lease agreement. Those of you that were at the workshop, Kevin came and told us about. Motion by Sue Nance, seconded by?
Second.
J.L. Davis. Any discussion, any questions?
Same amount of money, the contract.
Yeah.
Everything.
Contract is the same.
Everything like he filed.
Just an upgraded machine. Does more things than what the one they've got does. All those in favor, vote yes. Then press your confirmed button. Those opposed, vote no. Anyone wish to change your vote? Show us the vote. 12 yes, 3 absent. Marie Ayers, Wendell Bailey, and Terry Singley are absent. We have the Fourth Amendment to the Ambulance Service Resolution. Entertain a motion to approve that.
Make a motion to approve the amendment.
Motion by Rusty Orrick, seconded by Alvin Evans. Any discussion, any questions? All those in favor, vote yes. Then press your confirmed button. Those opposed, vote no. Anyone wish to change your vote? Show us the vote, ma'am. 11 yes, 1 no. Tom Hatmaker voting no. And 3 absent. Marie Ayers, Wendell Bailey, and Terry Singley are absent. Motion is approved. Next is the lease agreement with Cherry Artis, increased from $900 to $1,200 per month. Entertain a motion to approve the lease agreement. Motion by Alvin Evans, seconded by J.L. Davis. Anybody have any questions or discussion? Okay.
You know, you said that Brandon Tartan was using the office up there. Why he paying some kind of rent like Daddy is?
Well, originally there was part of it was the clerk, county clerk, paid for their portion, and then there's a portion that the county mayor just come down my budget.
Well, why can't Daddy's gonna have the budget?
That's not the way to. I don't know. That's not the way to live.
It's not fair. You know, one office has to pay their part, and another
Let's go ahead and vote on the lease agreement. Whatever we do with her is not what we do. We'll come in our sales and we can talk to Brandon about it and see what we can work out.
I'd like to work something out first.
Well, the lease agreement is just with the county. It's not with me. It's not with Debbie. It's just with the county.
My question is, did anybody ever talk to her about why they've raised the rent on the building when she's never done any improvements to the building at all? The improvements to the building actually came out of Debbie's budget in the county. All the improvement that's been done there, and then she raises the rent as soon as the new fiscal year comes up. So, what's that about?
I don't know.
Well, that's not, now that's not much financial reason.
Well, I didn't check out. Why didn't you check out? You all are more interested, be more interested in it than me, I guess.
Yeah, I am interested in it. The interest I have, if I have a word to say in this, is if I pay it, Mr. Pardon should have to pay it too.
Well, we can work that out.
Right.
I don't mind to do that.
You're paying it, I'm paying it, you should have to pay it.
I don't mind to do that.
You should be divided three ways.
Mr. Chairman,
the lease agreement.
Can we, when is the lease up?
Let's look back here and see.
Have we got another month? Would that give you an opportunity to discuss it with her and see if we couldn't get it at the same rate? Just kind of tell her if she don't want to keep it at the same rate, we'll look at putting her own building in. For that amount of money, we can buy a piece of property and build a building. Let me just give her the option, keep it the same, or we'll go somewhere else. Sure, Jay or Alvin or Terry could find another place over there. We'd build a building for that price.
The term of the lease, 3 years commencing on the effective date, continuing in full force effect through June 30, 2016. That's the initial term. The county is hereby granted an option to renew this agreement for an additional 3-year term. Rates to be charged by volunteer to the county pursuant to Section 3 of this agreement shall be new rates as may mutually be agreed to by the county and volunteer. If county does not desire to exercise this additional 3-year option, the county shall notify a volunteer in writing no later than 60 days prior to the termination of this agreement.
This one here is just for
3 years.
That's what you read.
Yeah.
I'm reading my notes.
No, I'm reading from the wrong agreement.
I thought that paper that we got the last meeting for 1 year.
Mayor, can I ask Mr. Coker a question while you're above? Mr. Coker, can I ask you a question? In lease agreements, usually, does it not specify who's responsible for that keep of that building?
Yes.
So do you know whether in our lease agreement with those folks there, who's responsible? Because we're paying for rent, plus we're paying for the upkeep, right?
And if it's why?
I don't have a copy of the lease in front of me.
Well, I don't find it in here. It's in your page. Yeah, the lease shall be in effect for a term of 12 months, commencing on July 1, 2013, and terminating June 30, 2014. Annual rent of $14,400 for a full year, commencing on July 1 and closing on June 30 of the same fiscal year, and monthly payments of $1,200 each, payable monthly in advance. Tenant shall at its own expense provide all utilities with exception of water and sewage, which shall be provided by the landlord. Landlord shall be responsible for upkeep of the outside walls and roof of the lease premises and shall be responsible for major maintenance and repairs within said business premises to include electrical, plumbing, heating, and air conditioning systems. Superintendent shall be responsible for all minor repairs and upkeep, including but not limited to exterminator, interior painting, and interior signs. Tenant further agrees to maintain premises in a clean and orderly fashion and to properly report required building maintenance to the landlord.
What have we done to the building? Anybody know?
The new carpet. It's remodeled. Everything in it's in that office in the past 6 months has been remodeled. Painting, new doors, new walls, everything. Carpet, countertops, many drawers, everything. Building. I can get a telephone from Richard tomorrow sometimes.
When'd you say the lease was up, sir?
I do not see on here where it is, but it's my understanding that it expires on June 30th of this year.
This year.
As far as the maintenance is concerned and the upkeep, those are always matters of negotiation between the parties, but in the typical lease, the owner is the one that's responsible for the roof, the structure, the heating and air conditioning, the plumbing, the major items that would be major items of expense, and the tenant is typically responsible for the interior items, the painting, things that are not structural in nature. Heating and air conditioning is something that kind of goes both ways. But I mean, I think like we've had on the building out here, you know, it kind of goes both ways. It's just a matter of negotiation. But typically, the landlord is the structure, and the tenant is non-structural items. Carpet. You know, that's a wear item. That's something that probably the lease should specify who is responsible for it. I would say that typically, probably the tenant would pay the cost of carpeting if they wanted to change it. That would be a matter of just the negotiation. It should be specified who is responsible for that. Especially in a building of size.
Thank you.
I'm fine with my part. I'm fine with everything I've done. It's what I wanted. And I feel like everybody that has an office in there should have to pay their part. If I have to pay mine. I'm talking the monthly lease on this.
Tom Hatmaker.
In quick conversations with Alvin, he says he thinks there's enough room over at the ball field. So if we have to this year, it's an area. I mean, it's an option, not this year, maybe next year. We might keep that in mind. I think Joel needs to hammer this out before we vote on this.
To build the buildings?
Sorry?
To do what? Are you saying?
Yeah, on what we're responsible for, what they're responsible for. We should know that stuff before we vote to approve something.
Is the carpet something that these companies have their own?
Yeah, I don't have a problem with that.
It's not one carpet for the whole thing.
No, there's three offices in there.
And if you wanted to change your carpet, you would just change your
office? Yeah, I did through my budget. Okay. All that was handled right.
It seems to me that if an individual office wants to change their carpet, that would probably be their own expense, but that again is just a matter of negotiation. If that were not the case, then you'd have to agree on how much per square yard would be allocated or allowed for a change of carpet, and how often that would occur. And of course, a lot of that depends on what kind of weather.
The carpet has nothing to do with what I'm talking about. Now that we've done, the state came in and told me I had to redo that office for security. She didn't have any security over it whatsoever.
Did she say?
No.
What
we had to fix it to where she has security to lock her doors when she goes out of there and lock it while she is there.
Somebody actually broke the door.
Yes. And the only problem I have is with the lease. I don't care to pay my part, but like I said earlier, everybody should have their part that's rented in there from the county. They have to pay. There's no free rides in this world, and I need to understand that.
Okay, we have a motion and a second to approve this lease.
Mr. Chairman, may I ask Davey one more question? Have we done anything to the windows or the roof? Have we replaced any windows?
I understand, and that's her deal. She's supposed to be doing that. And anything I've had a problem with, she's fixed it. The water heater, it leaked, she came in and had it done. The air, anything like that, she's done good with maintenance and stuff in that.
So, Debbie, what you're saying is it's not the problem with her
landlord. No.
It's basically being a fair share.
This is being raised, and it should be paid. The woman, people get raises every year, and she deserves it. But what I'm saying is, if I pay my part, then everybody has an office in there in the county should pay their part.
Can I ask one more question, sir?
Yes.
Aren't we just taking money and putting it into a building that doesn't belong to us? And if we moved out, she'd be able to take and rent that thing out. We're taking care of her building for her. Mm-hmm. So I think if we're going to stay there, we need to definitely do some negotiation on the lease and everything. Because it's just like for example, the Career Center. That's a county-owned building. Ethra rents it, pays the rent. We're responsible for the everything.
According to the lease is drawn.
I'll just throw one other comment here, something to be thinking about. But if a tenant has some kind of special need in the building, such as special drawers, cash drawers, security, special security, that would normally be the responsibility of the tenant. Although it certainly could be the responsibility of the landlord. Usually the lease would say that the tenant will take whatever steps are necessary to make the premises suitable for their own needs and uses. What I'm hearing you talk about here is mostly an allocation of how you pay for it between the county offices as opposed to her. You wouldn't normally put that in a lease. I don't think that one would pay a third of this or 25% of that. I think normally where you've got one tenant, which in this case, what I understand, one tenant is Campbell County. Is that right? And then how you would allocate that among yourselves would not be her part of her term.
It's not.
The lease would provide who would be responsible for maintenance and how much rent you pay and insurance, who would be responsible for the building and your own contents. But how you would allocate the rent would normally be an internal thing and not involving her. For example, just to give you one example, let's say that wasn't the case, and one of the office holders quit paying. You're going to terminate the whole thing? Now, that's what you'd run into. So you have one tenant.
Yeah. David.
Mr. Hatmaker is right in mentioning that the possibility of a future building in that area is probably in the best interest of the county. But I'd say this, if the county is going to maintain a presence there, then that's obviously something that we need to look forward to budgeting in the future. But we can't walk away from here now, because as of June 30th, the citizens in Jellicoe and on that side of the mountain wouldn't have any representation in that area. So, unless there's another building that somebody's got eyes on, we can't really not do this tonight. But we can plan for the future, next budget cycle or whatever, we can get some numbers together and try to put something where we can move out of there.
confused.
Mr. Young has pointed out to me that there is a term here that shows what the division and distribution of monthly fees from a monthly tenant would be. You can certainly leave that in there, but it's not really something that the landlord would be concerned with. She's interested in getting paid. She's out of care.
With $1,200 a month.
Yes. Whoever pays it would be okay.
Would that be fine to change that, just put it in as $1,200 a month? She's actually renting from from the county government.
You want to just strike that out first?
Put $1,200 in and Vince can work out the fee changes between you and the mayor.
Mr. Evans?
Yes, sir.
Would it be agreeable to you to remove under tenant and landlord further agree that first bullet point be just taken out of the lease? Middle ways of the page says tenant and landlord further agree that division and distribution of monthly rental fees by tenant, which is Campbell County government, shall be as follows. County court clerk area to be at the rate of $665 per month, and the county mayor area to be at the rate of $535 per month. That's all we would be taking out of it.
I'm fine.
Okay. We're amending the motion to remove.
How much is Debbie's rent now?
$665.
We're leaving hers the same, and okay, that's fine. Is that okay with you?
It did very well, so to remove that.
Yeah, that's fine. Let's go.
Yeah, the motion's been amended to remove bullet point number one under tenant and landlord further agree that. And the motion is to approve this lease agreement with Cherry Lee Arts. Everybody understand the motion? Bobby White.
Bottom line is that should have been in there anyway. It really should, because the county is responsible for 100%.
Right.
But I'm not necessarily that break the budget down into offices.
I thought that shouldn't have been in her lease. So. Okay. Right.
Maybe not.
That should have been a mutual consent. Really or disagree?
That's an in-house decision.
That's an in-house decision.
That's what
Debbie's
trying to do, is make an in-house
decision.
Yes, right.
Okay, so everybody, Johnny Bruce.
If we vote this down tonight, come June 30th, we basically close the door.
No.
No.
She doesn't have anybody else on that bill.
We've probably got 90 days to vacate. Is that correct, Joe? And that would give him time to renegotiate and see if she wouldn't go back to the original rate instead of losing the rent. She's not going to give up a renter that she's had as long as she's had us.
Joe, she is not. I mean, we're month to month now, I think. I think the original lease, and I may be wrong, I may be talking out of school, but I think the original lease is, I don't know, I'm not going to say anything. I may be wrong.
It provides here under paragraph 3, under additional terms. If the tenant continues to occupy the premises after the expiration of the term of the lease, with or without the consent of the landlord, said tenant shall be at the will of the landlord and shall be subject to the terms of this lease. What that means is, under Tennessee law, where there's no other provision to the contrary, it would require 30 days notice. And if there's no provision in the lease that provides otherwise, the notice is effective on the first of the month. So if she gave you a notice today, it would be effective on July 1, and you would have to be out by the end of July. If she waits until after July 1, then it would spill over into August. No matter what day of the month of July, the notice would be given. So no, it wouldn't be where she would just be able to throw you out. you know, there would be some time for you to talk if that's what you wanted to do.
Go.
The thing about it is, if the whole money they be spending, if you leave, you're gonna leave that there.
That's right.
That state.
I don't want to leave that.
Okay, we've got.
Just split three ways, just like it should be.
We've got a motion. We've got a motion to approve the lease for a year, beginning July 1, with the deletion of how the rent is distributed. Sue Nance.
Can I make an amendment that if the rent on the building be split three ways with the three occupants?
Hold it a minute. It's not up to the artist to decide on how we split up her thing. She's
no,
ready to get it.
No,
so much money.
Right.
As either vote it up or vote it down, and then you all work it out.
Yeah, that's right.
You're talking about elected offices anyway.
Right.
I thought
it was
a question.
Is there objection to the question? Seeing none, we're going to vote on the motion to approve this lease agreement with the deletion of bullet point one under tenant and landlord further agree. All those in favor, vote yes, then press your confirm to button. Those opposed, vote no. Anyone wish to change your vote? Show us the vote. Two, four, five, six yes, five no, and three absent. One, wait a minute, nope, we got six yes, five no. One abstention, and motion fails. Six yes, five no, one abstention, and three absent.
As the old guy asked David Crockett, what did that mean?
That means that the lease was not approved.
Okay, so we'll move right along.
So we'll negotiate a different set of circumstances. Hopefully it will be agreeable.
Just speak to her.
I guess I will call her in the morning.
Okay. But I'm voting for it.
Okay. Moving on. The waste disposal agreement.
Is she made or something?
No.
The contract for our... waste disposal with Scott County, Scott Solid Waste Disposal Company. The FMS committee approved the contract cost and so forth earlier. So now we're asked to approve the lease agreement.
With Scott Solid Waste?
Yes.
So moved.
Got a motion to hear a second. Second by Rusty Orrick to approve the waste disposal agreement with Scott Solid Waste Disposal Company. Any questions?
Mr. Chairman.
Yes.
Confirm that was $17.27 per ton, correct?
Yes. Any other questions? All those in favor, vote yes. Then press your confirmed button. Those opposed, vote no.
That's on your basis.
So. 12 month contract.
Initial 3-year term.
3 years.
With an option to renew for an additional 3 years. Okay, anyone wish to change your vote? Show us the vote, ma'am. 12 yes, 3 absent. Marie Ayers, Wendell Bailey, and Terry Singley are absent. I have one thing that was not on the agenda, that I emailed to everybody today. It's the contract between East Tennessee Development District and Campbell County providing for the local planning advisory services. It's the same contract that it was last year. And we'll need a motion to suspend the rules to approve it. This
motion to suspend the rules, Mr. Chair.
Got a motion to, and by Oryx, seconded by Johnny Bruce, to suspend the rules. It's the same. It's a contract for local planning. You're on the planning commission. That's what it's for.
Same thing.
Yes, same thing, same price, same everything. Motion is to suspend the rules. All those in favor, vote yes. Then press your confirmed button. Those opposed, vote no. Anyone wish to change your vote? Show us the vote. 11 yes, Bob Waldman votes no, and 3 absent. These rules are suspended. Now, need a motion to approve the local planning contract with East Tennessee Development District.
Motion, Chair.
Got a motion by Oryx, seconded by David Adkins, to approve the contract, local planning contract with East Tennessee Development District. Anybody have a question? All those in favor, vote yes. Then press your confirmed button. Those opposed, vote no. Should anyone wish to change your vote? Show us the vote. 12 yes, 3 absent. Marie Ayers, Wendell Bailey, and Terry Singley are absent.
Mr. Chairman?
Yes, sir.
Can you give us some accomplishments that they've done in the last year?
You'd have to ask somebody on the planning commission. On to the county commissioners. Mr. Johnny Bruce, Recreation Committee acted on policies, advertising and signage policies for the Lomas Young Park.
Did you pass those out?
I had 10 of them that I passed out to different ones. Did everybody get a copy of the advertising and signage?
Nine-eighths copy over here. I've got a copy.
The only change that the committee made is under sponsorship signage guidelines on the fourth bullet point. The second sentence says these permanent signs will be kept up throughout the new election terms, and newly voted Campbell County officials shall not remove such signage without a majority vote from the entire Campbell County Commission. And we are, if you all...
that to say a simple majority.
Right.
I just got a copy of that. Somebody emailed, but I just got a copy. And the only thing I really know that I was not sure about was if you bought a sign, I thought we were just going to leave that to the person that runs the park on getting the sign made, the right dimensions, about what the customer wanted, but placing it where he thought it should be with the openings that he has.
Right.
I noticed in here it said something about, putting it here, putting it there. I thought we were going to leave that up to the guy that run the park to direct the signs. I think you get into some things there. If you let someone buy a sign and dictate where to put it, once they start putting signs up, just let that person know that there's an opening here, here, and here. Is that okay? Because of,
we didn't specify that all signs would be placed down the right and left side
right.
Of the wall line.
Okay. And it doesn't matter. direction, right?
Yes.
Okay. I just haven't got a chance to read it there for much better.
Okay.
Okay.
Well,
and also, those that purchase signs this year, those signs will be up until April the 1st, 2014.
Ones that have already got their signs up will
remain up.
Will be maintained until the new contract goes into effect next April.
Any motion?
Yes, we do.
Second.
Motion by Johnny Bruce, seconded by Alvin Evans, to approve this advertising and signage policies, subject to Mr. Coker. Have you looked? No. Subject to Mr. Coker giving us the okay that they meet legal form and that grammatical errors are fixed and spelling. Everybody understand the motion? Anybody have any more questions?
How many changes do you have in there?
Just a simple majority, from change unanimous vote to a simple majority of the commission. That's the only real change. Others are just misspell words, grammatical errors, and then Joe's going to look at it for legal content and fix that.
So you should say simple majority?
Without a simple majority vote from the entire county commission. Everybody ready to vote? All those in favor vote yes, then press the confirmed button. Those opposed vote no. Anyone wish to change your vote? Show us the vote. 12 yes, 3 absent. Marie Ayers, Wendell Bailey, and Terry Singley are absent. Sue had asked about the sanitation fees. Can we just... No, we'll just we'll refer that to the sanitation committee. Okay, Mr. Rusty Orrick.
Yes, sir.
You have want to designate a no wake zone from the Calvin Morton Bridge.
Calvin Morton Bridge.
Or Albert Morton.
Albert Morton. To
east. East.
All the east. No wake zones. I've talked with John Gregg with Region 4 TWRA. We just need to approve something tonight to send them that this is what our wishes will be.
Okay.
And
got a motion by Orrick, seconded by Johnny Bruce, to designate as a no wake zone from the Albert Morton Bridge to the east.
What? I got some questions.
Yes.
CCO.
I'm assuming that east is going to be going
toward the city of La Follette.
Toward the city of La Follette, back up. What's on the what? That creek?
Big Creek.
Is that Big Creek?
That's Big Creek.
I think I'll look into
the
bridge.
That's too far.
Okay.
Typically, what you see on no wet zones, and I'm for it.
Oh, I understand.
When you have areas like that where people are swimming, almost all the lakes in Georgia and Alabama and all of them have no wake zones under any bridge. When you have a bridge, it's automatically a no wake zone for erosion purposes. But if you might consider saying from the bridge to...
Next bridge.
The only thing, David, is and you're just as much aware of as I am, how wide it is up through there. I think if we designate as no wake, I think they'll slow down in that area. But once they get up to the point there, I believe they're going to open on up anyway. But you know, there's probably not, what, an eighth of a mile on up to the bridge.
But when the water's up, though, I mean, you can go...
When the water's up, but now when the water's down, it's a creek. I mean, it don't matter to me. As long as we keep the wake zone around that area, but I'm afraid, once if you don't, it's
narrows it gets up in there when they come out of that hole, they're going to open it up anyway.
If you put it to 1,000 feet, it would take you around up to that pole.
You actually need...
You need to be so rolled. And I think that TWRA is going to actually look more in depth. I mean, they said that, yeah, we don't have a problem with it, but we want to come out, give us GPS coordinates, and I'm giving them tomorrow. And they'll probably come out and be like David. They'll probably say, we'll do a wake zone from this point, from the bridge to this point, but from there on, we're not going to do it. So, I'm open. I mean,
yeah,
the problem that I've been seeing, been fishing, been having other people call me and ask me about it, is we're coming through too fast. We had a problem last year, which has nothing to do with it, with people jumping off the bridge. A guy jumped through a bridge last year. Got hurt real bad, or jumped through a boat, I'm sorry.
Jumped
onto a boat.
But it
does.
It does.
So, I mean, and there's laws already against that, but we need to establish the wake zone wherever, but at least in the park area, and I'm fine.
Yeah.
Is that fine with you? I can amend my motion and take that.
And then come across, it'd be right there at our line.
You'd be, for what it's worth, you'd be better off. You'd be just as good to take in a portion of the launching ramp as well. Like, if you're at the ramp looking at the water, take in 500 feet or whatever to the left, take in the whole section to the right, and then over there where the island is, where that other little section comes in, you might start the no-wake zone there, and then continue the no-wake zone until you get 500 or 1,000 feet on the other side of the swimming area. And that way, when people come in, they know to shut down and idle through that zone, and then once they get clear, then they can get a
hybrid.
That's...
So, go ahead. You want to amend your motion?
Yeah, I'll amend it to say that we'll meet with TWRA, and we'll try to keep a wake zone right in that area and not pass that rock pulling out there.
So we want to designate a no-wake?
I mean, I'm sorry, I meant to get the coordinates, which that wouldn't have mattered to us anyway. We had to have a map to show them.
Around the
Lone Lachine
boat ramp, over past the Lone Lachine beach area. Does everybody understand that?
Now I got something else to add. Maybe. While we're dabbling in this pot, let's talk about what we might as well do, the same thing as Cedar Creek.
It needs to be done.
It needs to be done.
At the bridge, right?
At the bridge, like 150
or 200 or 500
feet.
Let's do this one.
Even
up this one. If that's fine.
That's fine.
Make two motions and come back with the Cedar Creek and Mayor. The same
we got the motion to designate a no-wake zone in the area of the boat ramp and around to the beach area of the Lone Lachine Memorial Park. Okay, we're ready to vote. All those in favor, vote yes and press your confirmed button. Anyone wish to change your vote? Show us the vote, ma'am. We've got 12 yes, 3 absent, Marie Ayers, Wendell Bailey, and Terry Singley. On this same subject, yeah. We'd like to have another motion.
While we're sending the paperwork for TWRA, I'm going to make the motion that we ask them to designate 500 foot or so
there on either side of the
Cedar Creek Bridge, and designate that as a no-wake zone as well.
I second that, man.
Second,
because actually, you're not going to ever keep them from jumping off the bridge, but you might slow the boats down to keep running.
You see where they put a piece of carpet beside the bridge? So
we got a motion to also designate a no-wake zone on 500 feet either side of the Cedar Creek Bridge. Any questions? Any discussion? All those in favor, vote yes, then press your confirmed button. Those opposed, vote no. Where did Alvin go?
And let me say, anything we dig on these two subjects don't matter if they decide they don't want to. But he said this is the way we need to handle it.
Okay, anyone wish to change your vote? Show us the vote.
Upon jail.
Yes. Okay, we got 11 yes, one abstention, and three absent. Marie Ayers, Wendell Bailey, and Terry Singley are absent.
Well, actually,
Alan's
absent.
Well, he abstained. I saw him.
Okay.
Bobby White.
I got one more thing, though.
Oh, wait a minute. That's right.
I mean, go ahead.
No, go ahead.
We talked about, you know, buildings being built out there at Wamish Young Memorial Park. That was from donations. I don't think you've met on any of it, did you, Johnny? I think we need to try to put some kind of little plaque, something that says this, and it may be something that he's against, that he may not want his name put on the side of it, but at least something says when it's erected and funded by that individual. And I'll make it into a motion, and
a motion to...
I do not want to offend somebody that gives us money.
Right.
I'll second that.
Can we make it a unanimous second?
We can. Yeah, unanimous. But unanimous, I would say. All commissioners. To erect a plaque showing Mike Malico's contribution to the press box concession stand.
The rest of y'all want to...
Okay, any questions? All those in...
Yes.
Yes, Bobby White.
Is this going to go by Mr. Bossier's football field?
It's baseball field. It is.
Yeah.
It is.
Melvin's got a sign.
He does.
He does.
Okay, all those in favor vote yes, then press your confirm the button. Those opposed vote no.
That's right. Oh, yes, sir. Doctor, when that comes up
in a month. Anyone wish to change your vote? Show us the vote, ma'am. 11 yes, one abstention, and three absent. Marie Ayers, Wendell Bailey, and Terry Singley are absent. Alvin Evans abstains. That motion is approved. Okay, now Bobby White.
We have Mr. David Reed here tonight. David met with the insurance committee and discussed the possibility of having a gave us some prices for county. But county general government has made the board bid. And so David is here. But David, if you'll kind of let everybody see you. If you have any questions,
let's get us a motion. We need a motion to approve the local government insurance pool and the Tennessee Risk Management Trust proposal.
Yeah.
I'll make a second.
Got a motion by Bobby White, seconded by Steve Rutherford. Mr. David Rutherford.
You want me to go over this or just ask for questions?
Anybody have a question or you want to know
what you're doing here?
Y'all have questions, it's the same thing. Bottom line is we've been living 5 years on their money. The easiest way I can say it. And now it's come time, the 5 years is up to get some of theirs back.
Well,
the easiest way I can understand.
Just give us just a percentage increase, David.
The percentage increase increases for the county government side with the LGIP is a total of 5.8%. The Board of Education of the Tennessee Risk Management Trust is an increase of 13.6%.
Anybody have any other questions? Okay, all those in favor vote yes, then press your confirmed button. Those opposed, vote no. Okay, anybody? David, you're going to ask that you're going to vote?
Nah, I thought I was voting for
him. Anyone wish to change your vote? Show us the vote. 12 yes, 3 absent. Marie Ayers, Wendell Bailey, and Terry Singley are absent. Yes, sir.
Do we need to do anything with the Pinecrest School?
We do.
The Board of Education voted last Tuesday, was that right, to deed the property to the county, from the school board to the county, and I had contacted the first volunteer bank to find out what the notes, I think the total of loans was $19,000 some dollars. They offered to take to settle for $14,000 some dollars. And then I sent them an offer of less than that. And once they get back with me, then I can tell you all whether what they want to settle for. But we have to, I assume we have to agree to take the property, don't we, Joe?
The school board's actually want to give it to us and let us take care of the debt up. Am I right, Josh?
That's correct.
Yeah, we voted last week. It was unanimous 8-0 to offer the county the property and let you all settle up with the bank on the debt. And that way you offer the firefighters owners of the area.
What we said, we'll cover the property.
Well, we were originally going to sell it a year and a half ago, because with you all, I'm not sure about this.
We need to suspend the rules.
That would be a good idea.
Yep.
Motion to suspend the rules by Johnny Bruce, seconded by Bobby White. Any discussion? All those in favor of suspending the rules, vote yes. Then press your confirm button. Those opposed, vote no. Anyone wish to change your vote? Show us the vote, ma'am. We got 11 yes, Bob Walden votes no, and wait a minute. We don't have 11 yes. We have 10 yes. Alvin Evans abstains. Bob Walden votes no. Marie Ayers, Wendell Bailey, and Terry Singley are absent. The suspension of the rules is approved. It
takes 2/3, isn't that right, Joe?
That's 10. Okay, now the next motion needs to be that the county commission will accept the Old Pinecrest School property on behalf of the county from the school board.
I'll make that motion, but there's some, going to be some monetary money that's going to have to take change hands somewhere, right?
Later.
Hold your breath, Josh.
We've got a motion to that the county commission will accept the property on the Pinecrest School property on behalf of the county from the school board. Is that cool, Joe?
Do we have some kind of a date whenever this will occur? I mean, when there's, you know, there'll need to be some documents prepared. And, you've got liability issues. We'll need to coordinate some things before this transfer takes place.
What do you suggest that we, how do you suggest that
we, well, there will need to be a deed made from the Board of Education to Campbell County. You'll need to get insurance changed from the board to Campbell County. You'll need to coordinate how possession is going to be transferred. These are not big things, but they'll just need to be done.
30 days, within the next 30 days, we have to find out. And
I would say to complete the transaction on behalf of the capital.
Yes, Johnny Bruce seconds the motion to authorize the county mayor to take possession of the Pinecrest School property from the Board of Education. Josh?
Mayor, the impression that the board gave last week was once we transfer this property to you all, we're done. Their intention was to allow you all to negotiate with the bank to provide fire service out in that area. So now that I want y'all to think that, I want to give the impression that I'm agreeing the board's going to pay anything once this transfer goes through. I just want y'all to know we're offering y'all this property to get it off our hands and provide valuable service.
The debt goes on there.
Mr. Chairman?
They don't take the property.
The debt's under $10,000.
No,
it's not.
Tom, that way.
Josh, we'll take it. We'll take it. We'd like to get a new roof first.
Well, you either take the property or you don't take the property.
So we're paying for paperwork. I just pulled the
thing.
Solar panels will pay for a new roof we put it out there.
We understand that we're taking possession of the property. Will allow me to sign the transfer of the deed from the school board to the county, and we have made an offer to the bank of about a third of what is owed on it. They're supposed to get rid of it today, but they haven't, but they should in the next day or two, and we can actually. Can we take this up? Can we finalize all this at the recessed meeting on the 27th?
Yes.
So if y'all approve this tonight, then we can go ahead and finalize all this by the 27th. Bobby White?
You're not going to come up on your offer.
No. No, we've made an offer.
And it's not going in?
No, and it's probably going to be accepted.
What was the offer range?
About a third of what it's owed again.
What is that third?
$19,000 something dollars was owed on.
But if we're actually in a dilemma out there in that area.
We don't have fire protection.
We don't. Well, we do, but they don't have a station to operate out of. They tried to negotiate with the old River Road service out there, which is privately owned. They won't let them use it. Yeah. We've got to come up with something to give them people protection out there to get their insurance back down. Yeah. I mean, some building somewhere or another has got to happen. School board has tried in the past to work with them. I think it's even tried to help them out by working around by actually letting them take loans on it, didn't you, Josh? That's where it all accumulated at. Well, we've got to have some place. The Wheeler Landing place is
the foreclosure.
It's forget about it. We've done gave that back to Jacksboro, where it should have stayed at anyway. They got Jacksboro's fire protection out there. You can't beat somebody that's getting paid to answer the calls. So we've got to come up with a place for them, and they've been really grateful, gracious to us to go out there and try to set up some.
Okay. All those in favor of the motion, vote yes. If the congressional confirmed button, those opposed, vote no. Anyone wish to change your vote?
Show us the vote. We have 11 yes, 1 abstention by Alvin Evans, Terry Singley, Marie Ayers, Wendell Bailey absent. Motion is approved.
Okay, now we need does anybody have anything, Tom?
Yeah, I got, in case somebody didn't hear it a minute ago, tomorrow night we got an animal advisory board meeting at 5 o'clock with all at City Hall. Thursday. We got an environmental committee meeting at 5 o'clock here. Not everybody was at the budget and finance the other night, so whether it be the mayor or somebody, one of us that was there, can you explain what took place with the summer intern program?
I was not there.
Well, our chairman, he's my the vice chair, wasn't there?
Can we recess to tomorrow night, in conflict with the annual advisory meeting?
That's what I was going to ask. Will it be tomorrow night or not?
I thought we recessed to Thursday.
Recess tomorrow night.
You've got budget and finances tomorrow night.
Six.
So we're going to try and...
The annual advisory meets at 5 o'clock. Shouldn't take you an hour to decide what you want to try to do.
Yeah. We should be done up there by 5:45, and they'll give us 15 minutes to get here.
Anything else, Tom?
Yeah. And I'm glad Josh is here. You know, we talked about the virtual schools things the other night. Just so y'all know, they're being run out of states that this was started in. A lot of times people get pet projects around here, and they make it look like a yellow brick road. This thing is not going to work. Some of the best graduation rates are up around 25-28%. So don't be disappointed when this thing comes back on us.
What was it again, Tom?
The virtual schools program.
July the 4th. Courthouse will be closed, but we will be open on the 5th. Beverly, we're open on the 5th.
Hey, Mayor, can I ask Mr. Coker one question? Just one question.
Yeah.
On the proposals for the property in Flat Hollow, you know, the home that was 90% complete, could you possibly send me or by email or something what needs to be in the proposal? And have we sent any to them yet or anything?
There's not been any sent in. Okay.
Did you get your question answered?
Yes, sir.
Okay, do we need a motion to recess to the 27th, Joe?
Yeah. Before we recess.
Okay. Rusty?
This lease agreement, you know, bring it back to the floor and try to vote on it again, and we'll wait for the next one. And this property will burn jelly.
I don't think that she's going to kick us out.
Okay.
It'll just stay at the rate that we're paying now so we can get it straightened out.
Okay.
I'm sure she's not going to try to kick us out.
Mr. Chairman, make a motion to reset June 27th.
Do we need to stay, say what we're going to do at that meeting, if it's some things that we haven't taken care of?
For unfinished business and to continue the discussion of our items that we're on this agenda.
Right. We're going to recess till 6 o'clock on June the 27th, 2013, to take up matters that were brought up tonight and that we need to have further discussion and take further action on. At the end of year budget.
Precious Lord, take my hand. Lead me on, let me stand. I am tired, I am weak and worn. Through the storm, through the night, lead me on to the light. Take my hand. Precious Lord, lead me home. In my way.
precious Lord, linger near when my life is almost gone. Hear my cry, hear my call, hold my hand lest I fall.